Thank you for the introduction. So the topic today is Secure Protocol Transformation. And the modified computation involves computation between two or more parties without revealing any information except the input and output. In order to capture potential attacks, there have been a variety of security models discussed since the start of digital MPC in the 1980s. For example, whether the adversary is malicious or not, whether output delivery is guaranteed or not, and what the operation of parties can be corrupt. In fact, there are more dimensions to discuss. So this makes the landscape of MPC protocol quite complex. Hence, a natural question is whether we can automatically transform results from one model into the others. There are a few motivations for the questions. For example, where we can unify or simplify classical results. For instance, BGWCCT-ADA provides a protocol with threshold 1/3, and Robin Panel 89 has a protocol with threshold less than 1/2. Can we convert a protocol in BGWCCT region into a protocol with higher security, like in the Robin Panel region? And through a transformation, we would also like to know whether the efficiency technique developed for one model can be extended for the others. Hence, the design of the protocol can be more modular with respect to the security model. And we also like to capture techniques that are used ad hoc in the literature as a transformation theorem, such as the pair elimination. So we have a few results in our paper. Firstly, we present a framework of bypass transformation. And we also give a few transformations in this setting. Applying this transformation to existing protocols in the literature, we obtain a few results as a corollary. And we also have impossibility results regarding bypass transformation. And so let's see the framework of bypass transformation first. Major object of interest in this framework is protocol scheme. A protocol scheme is a program that converts a functionality into a protocol. For example, YAUS double circuit is a protocol scheme that YAUS semi-honest secure protocols. And a black box transformation is itself a protocol scheme for a target model that use a source model as a oracle. But we have to be careful. So because what if the protocol scheme simply ignores the source model and construct a protocol for F from scratch, then it won't be a meaningful transformation, right? So we do not allow the bypass transformation to act on the functionality directly. It can only use F as a black box. For the example here, G can only depend on the F as a black box, and pi F is defined using F and pi G as black boxes. In general, the black box transformation can access the source model protocol schemes multiple times, and there can be multiple source models. So black box transformation can be used for security augmentation that transform weakly secure protocol schemes into a stronger protocol schemes. For example, the IPS compiler by Ishii uses a scheme of usage security with honest majority and a scheme of semi-honest security to get a scheme of usage security with no honest majority. Hence, it uses two weak secure source models and generate a target stronger secure target model protocol. And backbone transformation can also use for efficiency leveraging. That improve the efficiency of multi-party protocols by combining weakly secure but efficient protocols. For example, the breakout transformation uses a faster node threshold skin pi 1 and slow high threshold skin pi 2 to get a faster high threshold skin. It does not improve the security level of pi 2, but it does improve its efficiency by combining a faster protocol, pi 1. And so in our paper, we give several breakbulk transformations for both security augmentation and efficiency leveraging. A central theme of many of these transformations is a new security model called partial identifiable abort. And in this setting, the adversary is allowed to cause abort in time. But when an abort event happened, a subset of party is identified with at least a theta fraction of them are corrupted. For example, for one half identifiable abort, if two parties are identified in an abort event, then at least one of them is corrupt. So partial identifiable abort is useful as an intermediate security notion. For example, we can, if we want to get a full security proto skin from proto skins in BGW CCD region, we can take a partial identifiable as a intermediate step. So the transformation from partial identifiable abort to full security can be achieved by prior elimination. In each repetition, the active parties run the given protocol. And if an abort event happened, a group is identified with at least 50% of them are corrupt. And then we deactivate the group. And the procedure is repeated until there's no any more abort event. So if the initial set is honest majority, then the active set will always keep honest majority. To implement the idea, we require the input and output shared by error correcting secret sharing. And this can be done by a standard secret sharing plus max. So we expand the transformation from partial identifiable to full security. Let's see the transformation from full security threshold 1/3 and semi-honest security with threshold 1/2 to partial identifiable. To do this, we construct a new breakbulk transformation by modifying the IPS transformation. The basic idea of IPS is to run the virtual server in the head using an actively secure outer protocol and implement each server by a semi-honest secure inner protocol. And the corruption in inner protocol can then be weakly detected using a watchlist mechanism. In IPS, the watchlist mechanism is implemented using OT hybrid. But for the honest majority setting here, it's sufficient to use a weak OT. And weak OT can be implemented efficiently. In weak OT protocol, the sender has the input AB and receiver has the input X. And the receiver is expected to output X plus B. So in the first round, they send their the input, the shares of their input to all the parties. The parties compute the shares of X plus B locally. And in the second round, the parties send the shares X plus B to the receiver. And then the receiver reconstructs the value. Because any attack corresponds to adding a shift to X plus B, the security can be guaranteed by using AMD encoding. And IPS guarantees security with abort. The parties abort as soon as cheating is reported as by a watcher. Here we modify it to be a one-half identifiable abort. And so take an easy example. When the policeman observes from the watch channel that Mickey sent 5,000 and Goofy got 3,000, he will claim either Mickey or Goofy is lying. But from a public view, it can also be the policeman himself is lying. So to identify a set of two, we let Mickey and Goofy announce their views publicly. So if Mickey and Goofy has inconsistent view, then either one of them is lying. And if Mickey and Goofy has consistent view, then the policeman would be able to identify one who changed the world, like Mickey is lying. Or Goofy is lying. So combining these techniques, we have a transformation from proto skins in BGW CCD region to the partial identifiable abort. And we can improve the efficiency further by exploiting the honest majority setting and use an expander graph to specify the watch list. So applying this transformation to the existing protocols, we get the following corollaries. First, if we use an efficient protocol from Dunkard issue at 06, then we can get a constant rate protocol where the communication cost is only depends on the number of parties. And for large circuits, we have almost linear communication per party with an optimal threshold. Since our efficiency holds for no-width arithmetic circuits, it can be considered as a complementary result of Benson-Song, Fair, and Ostrovsky, which has efficiency for no-depth circuits. And applying further efficiency leveraging, we has almost linear total communication with near optimal threshold. This improves the near one-third the threshold in Dunkard issue and CoreGuard. And we also have ICOS like a zero knowledge, but from two-party multi-party computation, similar to the results of Kamin and Musu, by using a constant number of commitments. Okay, so let's go on the impossibility result. The first impossibility is functionally black box protocol. It's about functional black box protocols. And this first defined in Rossi Lake 12, assuming one-way function. And here we give an unconditional result. So functionally black box protocols consider transformations without using any source models and just produce a protocol by black box using the functionality. And the function family we consider here to show the proof is a Boolean function parameterized by a Boolean string, binary string alpha. And f alpha is y equals 1 if s is all y equals alpha. As another impossibility, we show there's no breakbulk transformation from semi-RNS to equilibrium security. And to show this, we assume the existence of one-way functions and consider a family of linear G proofs. Okay, so to sum up, I'd like to give you a take-home message. When developing a protocol for one model, consider its implication to other models through breakbulk transformation. Usually, it can imply quite a few corollaries. And when developing a new MPC technique, think about whether it's a breakbulk transformation. And there are many open questions found in the line. For example, we'd like to know breakbulk transformation between more models. For example, the transformation from synchronous setting to asynchronous setting. And we'd also like to know more impossibility results that separate the different models in a breakbulk way. And as for application, we'd like to see more and better MPC protocols through new breakbulk transformation. Okay. So thank you.